Good morning, St. Francis in the Fields. My name is Raleigh Langley, and it is good to be with you this morning, and I hope that you are doing great. And I hope to be coming to you this morning with some words of encouragement. And I want to share you a little bit about what we've done in youth group this fall thus far. Even during the pandemic, we are trying to meet every Wednesday night to do a Bible study. It's called Solid Rock. And this fall, so far, we've studied the book of Philippians, and now we're in the book of 2 Timothy, where Paul is an encourager. You know Paul. Paul was who was formerly known as Saul, who was the persecutor of Christians, and then had this tremendous conversion on the Damascus Road, where he went from persecuting Christians to being a Christian, joining in and loving Christians, and loving Christ. And so we as a youth group, and really me personally, as I've kind of gone, as I have dived into this book of Philippians and 2 Timothy, I've learned a lot about Paul and his heart for Christ, his love for the people that he has discipled. And I think we have some things to learn as well, as our youth have learned a lot. Last week, we covered 2 Timothy 1, and we learned some incredibly beautiful things. We learned about Paul's conversion, that he was really reminding Timothy about his conversion. Remember your conversion. And then he said, have confidence in your conversion. Then he wanted to do something about it. What's your contribution to the world? And I started thinking about that, and that's good news for all of us, you know. Think about your conversion, all the people who have spoken into your life to encourage us in the faith. And then, you know, have confidence in that. Paul says, don't be ashamed of the gospel. Don't be ashamed of this good news. And then go do something about it. Share that good news with others. What a great message today. I mean, for me, it's a great message because I want to hear this. I want to hear and remember about my conversion, how Christ came into my life and changed my heart. And I want to have confidence in that and not be ashamed of that so I can do something about it. So let me read from you 2 Timothy 1. And it starts, I hear Paul and I hear, you know, his love for Timothy all in this. It's 2 Timothy 1, starting with verse 3. I thank God, whom I serve, as my forefathers did, with a clear conscience. As night and day, I constantly remember you in my prayers, recalling your tears. I long to see you so that I may be filled with joy. Oh, what a beautiful greeting, right? Paul's love for Timothy. He can't wait to be with him. Recalling your tears. I just think that's powerful. And then he goes, I have been reminded of your sincere faith, which first lived in your grandmother Lois and in your mother Eunice. And I am persuaded now lives in you. So now Paul's encouraging, you know, about your grandmother's faith, your mother's faith, but that faith now also lives in you. And he goes, for this reason, I remind you to fan into flame the gift of God, which is in you through the laying on of my hands. For God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and of self-discipline. That is so powerful. God did not give us a spirit of timidity, but a spirit of power, of love, and self-discipline. I mean, Paul was a young man who was starting off on his journey. He went to encourage the church here, and Paul is encouraging him. You know, when you're in this church, be strong. And I think he's encouraging us, even through this pandemic, to be strong in our faith. Remember our conversion. Don't be ashamed of that and have confidence in it and do something about it. Today, what would that look like if we just took a moment to breathe in the love that God has had for us, the experience that we have had where God has changed our hearts? And maybe there are some people around us right now who could use some encouragement. Maybe we share the love of Christ with others. Maybe we care for them through a card, a phone call, a letter, or maybe somebody that you see in the store consistently, whoever it is, just take a moment and think about the people in your life who could use some encouragement. And then be strong. Don't be ashamed to share the love of Christ to them. and do something about it. I hope that you have an incredible day. I love you and I pray for you, and I look forward to being with you soon.